signal we're going to be looking to come to green next time by 40 laps, $4,000 up for grabs. Here in the 7th annual Hangover 40. McIntosh and Williams in row 1, Marlar and Cook in row 2, Welshan and Cardwell in row 3, Erwin and Breeding in row 4, King and Ogle in row 5, Ashby and Shelton in row 6, Miller and Mayfield row 7, Mitchell and Williamson in row 8, Cloer and Bailey in row 9, Eaton and Collini make up row number 10. The ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's showtime here at the 7th annual Hangover 40. That drag race into turn number 1. Donald McIntosh going to jump out to the early race lead. Down the back straightaway. Justin Williams going to be in second, getting some pressure from Mike Marlar and Ray Cook. But Donald McIntosh going to lead the opening lap here, trying to make it a three-peat and go three in a row here in the Hangover 40. Justin Williams riding in second as Ray Cook trying to make the top side work, trying to work around Mike Marlar. He'll split him almost. And he'll grab the third position away from Marlar as they race off turn 2 down the back straightaway. Jason Cardwell rides in fifth. Jason Welsh in sixth. Stephen Breeding seventh. The 22 of Russell Irwin is eighth. Ryan King ninth. Billy Ogle Jr. 10th. And Ray Cook looks to have a fast hot rod, trying to find a way around the 89 of Concord, Virginia's Justin Williams as they dance off 2 down the back straightaway. Cook trying to make down a high side work. Had a good run off 2 right there, but had to grab the binders. Right on Williams' back bumper into turn number 1. Marlar now, he'll look to the inside of that pair as they battle off 2 down the back straightaway. All this going on behind race leader Donald McIntosh. Justin Williams holding on to the second position, but here comes the Winfield Warrior. Looking beneath Justin Williams for the bright space spot as they race off turn at number 2. Ray Cook right there in the mix. They thought about making it 3 wide, but didn't. Marlar to the inside of Williams. As they work off turn at number 4, put Mike Marlar into the second position on lap number 7, but Ray Cook looks to the outside of him. Cook around Marlar now, and he'll grab the second position. As we'll have 7 laps complete this time by. McIntosh showing a way out in front as he's gotten into the process of working traffic. Bo Eaton, the first car that went a lap down, he'll set his sights on the 99 of Tom Collini and attempt to put him a lap down now. As we've got 8 in the books, field working lap number 9 of this 40 lapper. McIntosh showing away, Ray Cook in second, Mike Marlar third, Justin Williams is fourth, Jason Cardwell fifth, Jason Welshan is sixth, Stephen Breeding holds down the 7th position, Russell Irwin 8th, Carter Miller up the 9th, and Billy Ogle Jr. is 10th. As Collini will pull the 99 pit side, as Jason Cardwell trying to work beneath Justin Williams, and he's got the pass made. Put Cardwell into 07, into position number 4. As Ray Cook into 53 is reeling in the race leader slowly but surely. McIntosh trying to negotiate the 1 of Shane Bailey, and that's going to let Cook make a run on him. As they work off turn number 2, McIntosh now clear of Bailey and Cook to the outside. As they race into turn number 3 and coming off turn number 4, we'll have a dozen in the books. 12 down, 28 to go. McIntosh on the point, but he's getting some heat from the Tar Heel Tiger. D-Mac and the Tar Heel Tiger battling it out for the top spot. Down the back straightaway, they'll dance into turn number 3. Mike Marlar still holds down the third position. Jason Cardwell fourth. Justin Williams in fifth. And Cook right on McIntosh's rear bumper, drifts up a bit in 1 and 2, trying to get a run to the outside, off 2 down the back straightaway. Closes back in on McIntosh as they race through turns 3 and 4. We'll have 14 laps official this time. D-Mac trying to make it 3 in a row here in the Hangover 40, but the Tar Heel Tiger may have something to say about it. He'll look to the outside of McIntosh, down into turn number 3. Side by side, battle for the lead, off turn number 4. Give the nod to the Tar Heel Tiger at the line. He'll take the lead on lap number 15. Cook now out in front. McIntosh is second. The battle for the lead has allowed Mike Marlar to close in on the front two as well as they go around the slower car of Bo Eaton and fixing to come up on a gaggle of slower cars as they work off turn 2 down the back straightaway. Marlar now sets his sights on McIntosh, trying to grab the second position away down into turn number 3. Marlar to the inside of D-Mac off 4. McIntosh will hang on to it for the time being to the second position as Cook continues to drive away. They put the 14 of Johnny Cloer lap down. They set their sights now on the 5M of Scott Shelton. And Cook trying to work past him as McIntosh and Marlar battle for the bridesmaid spot. Second and third off of turn number two. Then it's about a half straightaway back, or better than a straightaway back now to fourth place running Justin Williams. He's worked his way back around Jason Cardwell. And we're going to have caution. Caution is out. As the one of Shane Bailey, the 69 of Carter Miller, loop them down in the center of turn one and two with 18 laps complete. And the field going to see the one to go signal at the line. Race leader Ray Cook in charge of the restart here. As Cook will be in charge of the restart, second place Donald McIntosh. McIntosh chokes the inside of that first Dixie double file restart row. And we'll see what happens here when they bring them off turn number four, coming back to the green flag with 18 in the books. Green flag waves, and here we go. They fan out down in the turn at number one. McIntosh and Marlar battling for second. Marlar nosing out in front of McIntosh. And Cardwell around Williams momentarily for the fourth spot. He's got that done. Welshan looking to the outside of Justin Williams now for fifth. Almost three wide there for fifth. Welshan will go to fifth. Move Williams back to sixth as he gets pressure now from Stephen Breeding for that position. And Williams dropping back, losing some positions here as Stephen Breeding challenges Jason Welshan for the final position in the top five. As they work off four down the main straightaway, as we're halfway into this one. 20 down, 20 to go. Ray Cook putting some distance now between himself and second place running Mike Marlar. Donald McIntosh right in position number three. Jason Cardwell, good run for the young man out of Knoxville, Tennessee, riding in fourth. Jason Welshan is fifth. Stephen Breeding sixth. Russell Erwin seventh. Justin Williams sits in the eighth spot. We got a car spun over in turn number two. Caution flag is out. 22 laps are official. Push on the car that's disabled over in turn number two. As Donald McIntosh's machine comes to a stop at the bottom of the back straightaway, and he confers with 411 Motor Speedway track officials. McIntosh will not make it three in a row as he is going to pull that machine pit side. Looks to be done for the night. Second place, Mike Marlar has chosen the outside of the first Dixie double file restart row. 22 laps are official. The Tar Heel Tiger, Ray Cook, in charge of the restart, bringing them back to green off turn number four, and here we go. Marlar challenges Cook a bit here on the restart. They'll race them down the back straightaway. Marlar looking to the inside of Cook for the lead off turn number four, but the Tar Heel Tiger will keep the Winfield Warrior at bay. Jason Cardwell third. Jason Welshan's made his way up to fourth in the Chicken Hawk. Stephen Breeding in the nickel, the number five, rides in fifth, challenging Welshan for the fourth position. Yes, Bo Eaton will pull the 3X machine into the infield. Looks like his night will be finished. Ray Cook looking high, wide, and handsome through turns one and two. A lot of guys have worked the middle and bottom, but Cook has worked up toward the top side of the racing surface. Yet his Capital race cars worked very nicely. Took the lead back on lap number 15. We're 25 laps into it now, and he continues to hold the top spot. Mike Marlar in second. He has those two putting some distance between himself and third place running Jason Cardwell in a 0-7. Jason Welsh in fourth. Stephen Breeding continues to ride in position number five. But Cook and Marlar may try to settle this thing amongst themselves if we stay green the remainder of the way. With a Baker's dozen, 13 to go here in the seventh annual Hangover 40. Cook in his own Capital race car this weekend has done a lot of driving in late 2016 for Stacy Bowles, but got his car out this weekend for this one. And Mike Marlar debuting a brand new Black Diamond chassis as they get prepared to go to the Wild West Shootout out in Arizona next weekend. And Cook with the lead and Marlar riding in second at this point as they've got about three quarters of a straightaway back to third place running Jason Cardwell at this point. And if we stay green, they are going to have to start working traffic once again. As we'll come down, there'll be 10 to go this time for race leader Ray Cook. 10 to go. Marlar is second as they try to negotiate the one machine of Grayson, Kentucky, Shane Bailey. Marlar looks to the inside of Cook. Cook will cross it back over right in front of Marlar and go to the bottom and close the door on him down in turn up three and four. Marlar trying to find a way around Cook at this point with less than nine to go. Cardwell rides in second, Welshan third, Breeding fourth, Breeding fifth, Erwin sixth. Welshan is in fourth, Cardwell third. Yes, the front two of Cook and Marlar continue to drive away from the field. They're going to set their sights to lap the double zero of Lenore City's Ruben Mayfield here momentarily, as there'll be a lucky seven laps to go this time by off turn four, seven remains. Yet Mayfield moves up and gives the lead pair plenty of room to race off turn two down the back straightaway. Cook and Marlar put another lap in the books. We've got six to go. Six laps remain. Marlar looking to the inside of Cook again in two, not able to get the job done. This group of traffic in front could tell the tale, though. We're going to have five to go this time right here. As a Marlar, or Cook and Marlar, they run 1-2, and they're fixing to get into some heavy traffic if we stay green to conclude this one. Cook trying to work between Johnny Cloer and a 14 and a 5M of Scott Shelton, and he looks to have part of it done through turn 3 and 4. Around Cloer, he'll work to the inside of Shelton now, and he'll put the lap car of Shelton between himself and second place running Mike Marlar at this point. Marlar dives back to the bottom of Cook as they work off turn number four. Not able to get the job done. We'll have three to go in the seventh annual Hangover 40. Street stocks, you should be in line and ready to go. You're coming up next. Cook working down the back straightaway one more time. They'll come down and there will be two laps to go this time. Two to go for race leader Ray Cook. Marlar dives to the inside as they work around the slower car. Billy Ogle Jr. closes up on Cook's back bumper momentarily. They're diving and slicing between traffic as they work off turn number four, coming to the white flag. One lap to settle it in the seventh annual Hangover 40. Marlar with one more shot at Cook as they race down the back straightaway for the final time and into turn three. Marlar dives to the bottom off of turn number four. The Tar Heel Tiger, Ray Cook, will get the win. Mike Marlar, he will come home in second. Third will go to Jason Cardwell, fourth to Jason Welshan, and at the line, fifth, I believe, is going to be Russell Erwin. And we get a few words with the winner. Ray Cook, congratulations, took the lead from Donald McIntosh on lap number 15, but Mike Marlar made you earn that thing about the last 10 or 12 laps. He dogged you, but could not find a way around you. You worked lap traffic just a tick better than Marlar did, and you put you 53 here in victory lane.
Well, our capital race car was very maneuverable today. We could run high or low, but when I get in lap traffic, I was just a little free, you know, and that's where Mikey was better than me. But just thank the Lord for a safe day. Thank all these fans for coming out on this rainy, cold end of the year day. And just thank the Lord for the blessedness with another year. And man, I got a lot of people to thank here. American Race Tires, Capital Race Cars, Gary Winger with Integra Shocks, Joe Denby with A Plus Moving and Storage, Schaefer Oil. I know I'm going to leave somebody out, but don't get offended at me. We appreciate everybody that helps us.
And you talked about working the high side there. Early on, it looked like maybe your race car was kind of married to the high side, so to speak. But once you got into traffic, you talked about the maneuverability of your race car. I believe you found out you could go just about anywhere you wanted to go at that point.
Yeah, the car was good. It's just I favor the high side myself. I ain't got enough patience to run around the bottom most of the time, but anyhow, we could go down there if we needed to, and just glad it worked out.
Give him a big round of applause once again, Rays fans. Ray Cook, the winner of the 7th Annual Hangover 40 here at 411 Motor Speedway. And we'll jump back here and get a few words with our second place finisher, Mike Marlar. You got around Donald McIntosh, got to second right there, and you dog Ray Cook the last 10 or 12 laps of that thing, but you just couldn't find a way around him, but you'll have to settle for second place, but congratulations.
Yeah, congratulations to Ray winning the race there. He sure made all the right moves. There was a couple of times I thought he might have a little spot, and he'd just dice right in the right position. So awesome race, and man, you know, I'd like to thank everybody for coming out today and watching this. Turned out really awesome, I thought.
And you debuted a brand new Black Diamond race car here this weekend, and you got to be pretty tickled with it, first time out of the box.
Yeah, we my car owner just got this car three weeks ago, and it's the first race, and we actually come over to race, and we're going to go to Arizona and race. So had a good car today. Liked, you know, it really worked good.
Give him a big round of applause. Mike Marlar, runner-up finish here in the 7th Annual Hangover 40. And we'll jump back here. And, young man, I know it's got to be tickled with this third-place finish, Jason Cardwell out of Knoxville, Tennessee. Young man, you drove an outstanding race. Probably a little bit underpowered compared to some of these other guys, but you took that 07 race car and come home a very respectable third place. Talk about your effort here tonight.
Thank you. Yeah, we're down on power. We're probably down 200 horsepower, but I can't thank Junior Weisgarber with Phantom Racing Engines enough. He does a great job. And I think all my sponsors, Mighty Muffler, Brown and Roberto, Phantom, and Shorty Shock Service.
And I know you race here a lot. You got a lot of laps around this place. When these guys come in here, you got to feel like you got an advantage on them, even if you are underpowered just a little bit.
Yeah, I don't think I ever have an advantage on these guys. I'm just tickled to get to race against a group of guys like that.
Give them a big round of applause. Third place finish in a Hangover 40, Jason Cardwell out of Knoxville, Tennessee.